Hey guys, today we're going to do a quick review on something that a lot of arcade fans have been waiting for a long time. Mike's Arcade has finally come out with true reproduction Nintendo buttons. Now, to the average collector or novice, a button's a button, right? You know, what's the big difference? But you probably can't tell on these, but like a Miss Pac-Man, the Leafs switch buttons. Those are just kind of the standard ones, and they have a certain height and a certain feel. But Nintendo buttons are very unique in the fact that they sit a little bit taller up in here. This is an original. These are the Mike's Arcade reproduction buttons that came out a few years ago. And what's unique about these buttons, like I was saying, is that they kind of have a unique shape slightly that, you know, the expert arcade nerds would notice. They sit a little bit taller, and the spring resistance is very unique to them. So over the years, people have been wishing that they could get a true reproduction for the Nintendo buttons. And Mike's Arcade finally went through all the trouble of having them manufactured down to the littlest, most minute details. And I got a set here, and we're gonna pop them into this Donkey Kong and kind of take a look at what's different about the reproduction ones, and what, if we can tell, you know, what's different between the originals and the reproductions. Pretty sure everyone knows how to pop off their control panels. All games are pretty similar. There's usually a couple latches, one on either side. You just kind of reach up and under. And Nintendo's one of the easiest ones to pop off. Here it is. And there's just a couple connectors that get disconnected. On the back side, you can see here. So this is what we're replacing today. This is an original switch, and I don't know if you can tell, but my button is practically like falling apart because of the E-clip. It hardly has a place to latch onto because a lot of times the plastic on the bottom of these is messed up. So, and these are Mike's Arcade Nintendo buttons that came out a few years ago, and they just don't have the resistance of an original button. So I'm excited to try out this new set. And here it is right here. So let's take this out to the garage and pop these in and see what we think and do a little bit of a comparison. All right, so we're out here in the garage and I've already loosened up these nuts on these. Let's get these taken off here. So like I said, this is an original. And of note, when you order these new reproduction buttons, make sure that you get these nuts with them, because these are metric. The last reproduction set, these right here, are not metric, so these will not fit on the new buttons, and they will also not fit on the original Nintendo buttons. So you want to make sure that you get these new ones that are included, because they're metric, and these are metric buttons. So the original Nintendos were metric too. So this is an original button here. So, all right, let's get these other ones off. As you can see, like the blue button, that's the Mike's Arcade reproduction that came out a few years ago. And then that's an original orange button on the right. So you can see how it sits a little bit taller. And I know you can't obviously feel it, but this has a little bit more tension than this. And the reproductions are supposed to just have like perfect spring response and be very similar to the original. So Mike put just a ton of effort into this project. This was initially a Kickstarter, and the goal was to reach $7,500, and he raised close to $4,000, which is pretty impressive when you think about the fact that it's for buttons. You know, like this hobby is obviously kind of unique. And it's hard to find that many people to invest in something as silly as buttons. But to collectors, it's very important to have as original of a product as you possibly can. And that was the case here. And, you know, everyone was just really pushing for this to happen. Unfortunately, the Kickstarter fell short. But Mike was awesome enough to say, you know what? We got to make this happen one way or another. And he had a manufacturer. He had a manufacturer for the Eclipse, for the nylon buttons, for the springs. So he really put an insane amount of effort into making this all happen, and the arcade community on Clove and you know other places is just ecstatic, and he's been selling these like hotcakes. So I'm going to provide a link and everything, but make sure you get to mikesarcade.com and get a set ordered. If you have a Donkey Kong or a Versus system or a Mario Brothers system or a Red Tent, he has every single color, even for the Red Tent. The greens, the purples, and it's like the exact insane shade, because those shades were really unique. It's not just a standard purple. It's like a weird dark grayish purple. And the greens, there's like almost like a mix of gray in the colors. It's kind of weird. But they were very unique to Nintendo cabinets, and if you want them truly, you know, when you're doing a restoration, if you want truly done right, that's what you want. So these are the new buttons, and we have the proper metric nuts here as well. And so, those are awesome. I know you can't tell, but those are awesome. And the blue is spot on. So let me show you the blues compared to the mics that came out. The lighting's not all that great in here. But if you can see, this one sits a little lower. This one's like a darker shade, not quite as glossy. Let me see if I can put the light on this. And as you can see, this one's like a lighter shade of blue, a little bit shinier. And this one's like that very unique Nintendo blue. I don't know what else you would call it that's unique to Donkey Kong. And this is the most important set. Everyone wants these for their Donkey Kong. I mean, obviously the other systems too, the other arcade machines. But this is the one everyone wants, is the Donkey Kong set. So you can see it sits a little bit taller. But it's just done so well. This is rounded more to the original. And these were great. These were great buttons. I'm not knocking them, but it just wasn't, they weren't Nintendo buttons. So we finally got them, and we're going to get these put in. Let's see. Actually, let's do a little original. What's this one? This is my original Nintendo button. See, this is the Mike's Arcade. Let's switch sides here. I'm probably confusing everyone. So this is an original Nintendo, and this is the Mike's Arcade new reproduction on the right. So pretty stinking close. And obviously this one's going to show some signs of fade because it's 30 plus years old. So spring resistance is, they're just awesome. They're pretty spot on. Maybe a slight shade variance, slight maybe, but you're not going to do any better than this. So let's get these popped into the machine, and then we'll play the game of Donkey Kong. And obviously, you know, new buttons are going to add like 40,000 to 50,000 points to your high score, or whatever that may be. So I'm sure these buttons are just going to make a massive difference in my Donkey Kong skill. So we'll definitely have to check that out. So another thing you can do, just if you want a little bit more resistance with your the distance your button travels when you press on it, if you unscrew this little screw right here, you can adjust the height of the cherry switch so that it doesn't have to travel as far to go make contact with the switch. So just something to know, that's not typical of every arcade machine. But it can be pretty important, and super good Donkey Kong players are very anal about that. So they know exactly what length their button should be when they're pushing down on it, and the resistance and all of those things. So just of note, if you're a new Donkey Kong owner. All right, guys, we got our new buttons installed, and they're awesome. Definitely feel much more like the original Nintendo's, and the spring resistance is dead on. Huge upgrade compared to the other reproductions that Mike used to sell, and you know, just sticking a regular leaf switch in there. So regular style button, I mean. These are spot on, colors just perfect. Pick up a set. I think I paid $30 for these shipped. So you can get them on mikesarcade.com and help support the cause, because Mike invested a lot of money, a lot of time, a lot of headache. But anyways, pick up a set of these. Let's see how we do with the game. I'll hit the lights. Because, you know, the buttons make all the difference in the world. Which you guys might not know is I'm terrible at this game. Can you guys see? No, you can't see. Now you can see. Alright. So yeah, you could have the best buttons in the world, but Donkey Kong is one game that I'm just terrible at. But the response is way better. Let's see if I can jump all three of these. With my old buttons, I couldn't do that. I adjusted the cherry switches a little bit, and that made a huge difference. Oh, that was my own fault. That's right, guys. I have 800 points on my first life. So, you know, just because you own an arcade doesn't mean that you're fantastic at every game. Especially Donkey Kong. Donkey Kong is brutal. I'm just kind of screwing around here. Almost got killed by that barrel. Let's just jump some fire. See? Terrible. I'm not really trying. I'm just trying to make sure you guys can actually see. But the buttons are awesome. All right, let's just at least finish the first level. Let's just run through it real fast. This is embarrassing. Now you guys know I'm a terrible arcade player. Oh, freaking frack. Whatever. At least the buttons are awesome. So yeah, stop by mikesarcade.com, pick up a set. He has the Nintendo Versus buttons, the Red Tent buttons, and obviously he has the Donkey Kong proper blue and orange button. So pick up a set, help support the cause. They are selling out very quickly. He's already had to place an order for a second run, depending on when you're seeing this video. So hopefully you can still get a set, but don't hesitate. Don't wait a little while. Order them now, because they're selling out very quickly. And these are the real deal ones that you want in your Donkey Kong or your Versus system or your Red 10 or whatever Nintendo cabinet you have. You want the proper Nintendo buttons. If your old ones are all beat up and have cigarette burns on them, this is as best as you are going to get. So thanks very much to Mike at Mike's Arcade for making this happen. Arcade fans are just thrilled, and we definitely appreciate all your hard work. I know I'm speaking for all of the club members, so thanks again, and be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and thanks for helping this channel grow. And we'll talk to you guys soon, and we'll be showing some other arcade stuff going on. All right, take care, guys. Thanks again.